so many.
Both petals and flowers, they're producing over and over and over again.
Yeah, I will go and help her.
You can also come to Hawaii.
Yes, you should come.
I want to come, but Brittany won't let me.
Oh, but no harm if you are not. I'm with you. Yeah. Taking care of my business.
Okay.
Because then if it's out, then you'll have to manage.
Gurudev, we cannot bring the picture of Param Gurudev this time.
What?
The picture of Param Gurudev?
No.
I can bring in Kartik, it's difficult.
Oh, okay. Very, very. All pictures. No.
He will make some photographs
also.
Guru
Parampara also, yes, at that time you can bring.
We are liking him to come here to New Braja.
You should come here or you can give your help in training hall, making hall.
If you would just say specifically which place, then I will go to that place. Does everyone say maybe here? Yeah. Maybe
we are trying to make
decision.
Anywhere. We are making preaching center. I want to make you head of
servants.
You are qualified to do
England.
If but England, you have some problem. Wife problem.
Not PY, ex
wife. Actually, let me see. When
American Express.
And when we do pronounce that, I mean, oh, Kalyanam Bhavatu, Kalyanam Bhavatu, Kalyanam Bhavatu, Kalyanam Bhavatu. Oh, let me know. Yes, sir. Oh, Kalyanam Bhavatu.
I want to ask you a question. This year, we have so many rattlesnakes. The grass is very tall, and when we find them, should we kill them? They're poisonous snakes.
Anywhere.
Anywhere around our
devotees' homes. Sometimes the rattlesnakes come.
Oh, so you should clear.
Take them away.
Don't try to kill them, but you can take them. Snakes?
Poisonous
snakes.
Just take them away, don't kill them.
Try. And if necessary,
you can pull them.
Because that's
the Gurudev, after our Govardhan, after the Govardhan festival, when all the devotees left, the peacocks came and they went on the hill. They were eating, taking remnants.
It's so beneficial. Maybe I'll become your peacock. Oh, my mouth.
Namadip Prabhu, Govind all
ashes. गंगा जमुना तुलसी भक्ति वृंदा देवी की जय सर्वाक्षर गिरिराज गोवर्धन की जय भक्ति बिन विनाशन करी नृसिंह देव की जय भक्तराज प्रहलाद महाराज की जय अनंत कडी वैष्णव वृंद की जय ग्रंथराज श्रीमद भागवतम की जय ग्रंथिर वक्ता सदा वृंद की जय समवेद गौर भक्त वृंद की जय गौर प्रेमानंदे
अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन tasmai sri gurave vancha kalpatarubhyasya kripa sindhubhyaye vacha patitanam pavanibhyo vaishnavibhyo namo mahavadanaya krishna prema pradayate krishnaya krishna chaitanya namne gauratrise gurave gaurachandraya radhikayai tadaye krishnaya krishna bhaktaya tadabhaktaya namo yang prabrajantam anupetam apetakrityam dvaipayano virahaka tarya juhava putreti tanmayataya tarvogini tam sarvabhutaridayam tavaivasmi tavaivasmi najivami tvaya vina iti vigyaradhe tanmayam Now you should be ready to come with me to fly India. And then at once come with me in Vrindavan. From Vrindavan we are going now to Gokul. Where Gokul? In the palace of Nanda Baba and Yashoda Maiya. No? And you can see with me there. Krishna is taking breath of his mother. And Yashoda Devi giving her breast milk to his Lala Kanaiya. And there is a competition. Krishna is too much hungry and Yashoda Maiya has so much milk, more than Birja or Kshirsagar or anything. So there is not chance, any chance, that this ocean of milk will dry, and there is no chance that Krishna stomach will be fulfilled. Never. But in the meantime, there was a milk pot on fire, and the milk was
overflowing.
Overflowing.
Overboiling. Overboiling and overflowing.
It had cut all down. So, just so that, very good, very good. Mother Yashoda saw that milk is
overflowing,
overflowing,
overboiling,
and it was falling on fire. Yashoda became very merciful. She thought that milk on this pot is thinking, because they are all transcendental. Oh, he is thinking that I'm not going to be accepted by Krishna. I am so unqualified. And Krishna is engaged in taking the milk, best milk of my mother Yashoda, and I will always be neglected. So if I am not doing serving Krishna, so what is the use of keeping my life? So all devotees should think, and really the devotees, they think that if I am not serving my Gurudev, why I am going to serve my Gurudev? Only to serve Krishna, conjugal. or Mahaprabhu or Nityananda. But this is not served, we cannot hope less than no use of keeping life. We should try to serve Radha Krishna conjugal. But if we cannot do, then no use of life. That is why Narottam Thakur is telling, why my pran is here, my life is here? Why not coming out? I don't want to
keep my life
for a moment because I'm not serving Krishna and Radhika. I'm not being qualified, so I should die. So that milk was thinking that I should die burning in fire, so it was coming. Yashoda Maya, like a guru, she thought that I should go and at once I should save his life. So, to give a chance for that milk or any devotees, Guru sometimes, leaving the service of Krishna himself, and comes down and they help devotees, that I am giving chance you to serve Krishna. You should serve Krishna first and then I will serve. So Gurudev is so merciful. Yashoda Maiya. So and at once she wanted that I should running away go there and save that devotee. But Krishna was taking milk. When he saw that Yashoda Maiya wants to keep me from her lap to down on earth, oh, she became like monkey boy. And he catch hold very tightly, here, there, with legs, with mouth, very tightly, and with hands, so tightly, with legs,
waist.
Like monkey, you know. Have you seen Indian monkey? Very expert.
Vrindavan monkey.
So Krishna, he was not satisfied, so he wanted to take more milk. But now he has tightened her mother. But mother was so in hurry, so, oh, with one hand, very easily, oh, you should sit here. And Krishna was controlled and he was, he sat there. But he was so angry. You know that Putna was so
powerful.
So powerful, having the power of
60,000 elephants.
50,000 elephant, not horses. 3 horsepower, 4 horsepower, not like that.
60,000
elephant power. An elephant has perhaps how much?
With
so many horses he can do like this and oh, like that. No? So much power. And Krishna easily was shocking her breast. No use power. But she could not get rid of Krishna. And here Yashoda, Krishna engaged his all power. 6 kinds of opulence there. So much power. Being supreme personality of Godhead, supreme personality of all powers. But she cannot do so. Easily Yashoda kept him. Oh, sit down here. And she ran. Then Krishna was thinking that, oh, Yashoda has so much prem for, love for
Krishna.
No, milk. Not to me. And he wanted to cry and weep, but now he has some anger. And so first he wanted to do something and then weep. So he wanted to
turn over
that pot with all curd and everything. He wanted, but he was so weak that he could not do anything. Then he searched any other way. There was a stone there.
Vessel.
Indian ladies, they use in mashala.
This is called vessel.
Very little. And his thought was so clever and tricky that upper part so much thicker and lower part so much thin. And if I will break it on the top, all liquid will not go away. So all liquids will go away because mother has left me. And that is why he took that stone and made a hole in the bottom very easily. And then when liquid was coming, white, then he was looking that, oh, how beautiful, coming, and everywhere,
how marvelous
spread. After that, he has this thing that he became
scared.
He had fear that, oh, mother will come and see and chastise me.
And beat me.
Not only chastise. What she will do?
Beat me bitterly.
Beat me. So, he discovered a way. He saw there is a room. Having two gates. One coming to courtyard and one to go out of
front.
Courtyard or home outside on the roadside. And quickly he entered that. And there were so many
hanging rope,
full of
butter pots, hanging. And there was a
grinding mortar
there was. And he
climbed up
there and very easily used to take from all others. Sometimes taking himself and sometimes giving to monkeys. Why to monkeys? Because monkeys in Treta Yuga, they have served Ram, that is Krishna, with their life and soul, not wanting anything in return that, oh Ram, you should supply us some fruits or anything, nothing, and giving their life in battle. So Krishna thought that, I have not repaid anything. So now is in this
time has come.
And he was giving butter to all. And also some crow came. And he was distributing to. Why? Because there was a Kagbhushundi in the shape of a crow, a very high class of Ram devotee, always remembering him, always preaching in the whole world. So he wanted to also do something for their generations. So he was distributing to. Just when Yashoda went there, he consoled. How? With some water taking his hand and sprinkled like this. Oh, don't give your life. I have come to save you. First, I will give you
chance
to serve Krishna, and then I will serve. So Guru died like this, very merciful. After that, when she returned, when it came down, she took off that pot from fire, kept anywhere else, and he quickly returned. When he went there, he saw that, oh, where is boy? Where is Krishna? She began to search. At once she saw that all the liquid has come out of this. And he began to laugh. I see, very
naughty.
Tricky, naughty. I will give a very
good lesson
to her. But Krishna was not there. Any thief wants to, does not want, he never keeps any
sign
of that he is same person, so that he may not be caught. Understand?
Evidence.
What?
He never leaves evidence.
Any evidence. What I want to tell.
He never leaves any evidence so that people will catch him.
But anyhow, he leaves some
evidence.
Evidence. That is why police comes and they catch hold. By their dogs or by anything. By foot friend, by anything. So Krishna has kept there his footprints. At that time he has not think that these footprints will help Mother Yashoda to chastise me. So now Yashoda, with this clue, he knew that Krishna has entered in this room. And quickly she took a
cane
in her hand and tipped like this. Oh, where is Krishna? He saw that he is standing on a mortar. Yeah?
Grinding mortar.
Grinding mortar. And taking
butter
from there and dividing in all monkeys. But he was also looking that like this towards door. That if mother will come, I will at once fly. Yashoda Maiya saw that he is now giving. So quickly, like a black cat, like this.
Tiptoe.
You know that if there are so many dry leaves, and cat will go, walk, but no sound. Very
soft.
So Yashoda Maiya like this, entered in the room, and in the shade of any kavat.
Door.
And she was taking, thinking to have any chance to
catch him.
But when he was so nearer and about to catch, in the meantime, monkeys
run away.
Began to run and crossed also like this, going. Then Krishna, they said, why they are running? At once he saw that mother with a stick is coming. And he is about to
catch.
At once he jumped up from there. And run on the road he began to run. Yashoda Maiya told, anywhere in the world you will go, I must
catch you
and chastise you. Krishna thought that mother will not come and just follow me because Indian ladies, they have so much shame to go out. And if any how they have anything to go out, they will take their bells like this. So with bells they cannot run. Yashoda Maiya told that you have come from my home, I am more
intelligent
than you. Today there are now no one here in village this. All have gone to cowherd. So today is so free, I will run. But Yashoda Maiya was
healthy,
very fat here, very. If anyone see her, and if she is bending, anyone can think that, oh, she should not
break
here. Very beautiful, very soft. But today, he took his bell here and began to run. And Krishna quickly began to run. You should know that any Mahajogi like Sukadeva Goswami or Narada even, high class of yogis. They are all, heart is so pure, but they cannot in their trance take the son of Krishna, lotus feet. They cannot touch. But Yashoda Maiya, in this body also, being a gopi, and he began to quickly run. If anyone is running and I want to catch him, then I will have to run more than
faster than
that person that to whom we can catch him. So Yashoda was running more than Krishna. What is the meaning? Krishna loves his devotees. But if anyone wants to control Krishna, he will have to love Krishna more than Krishna loves you. Understand?
Mm. Yeah.
Krishna has so much love and affection for us, but say devotees has much more love and affection than Krishna has to us. Then he can control. That is why Srimati Radhika has how much more love and affection that Krishna has to Radhika. Radhika has much more affection to Krishna than Krishna has to Srimati Radhika. And that is why Krishna always controlled by Srimati Radhika. So if anyone wants to control Krishna, he will have to love Krishna more. Yashoda has also more affection. She was running quickly. Those, but being some sthool, healthy, and Krishna now not so much bigger.
Very slim.
But quickly running, and from this to that zigzag way, that Yashoda wanted to, oh, I have caught hold, but at once he used to go there. She could not catch hold. Now he was somewhat taking so long breaths. Then he searched a way that the stick which has she has. Oh, Krishna, see, I'm giving up you, throwing. So Krishna did like that, and he stood up. Mother, don't beat me.
Beat me.
That's what I told you. Why? Why I should? I have done no offense. Oh, you have done no offense. Why you broke the pot? Krishna told that, I have not broken that pot. Who has broken? You, mother, you have done. How? When we are quickly running to save the milk, in your legs you have so much
thick and heavy.
Of golden, very powerful.
Very thick and heavy. And
so anyhow, it was
stuck.
Stuck and it was broken. I have not done. Oh, you are liar. No, mother. I'm no liar or other thief. It may be in your dynasty. Anyone was thief. But in our Baba dynasty, no one is thief, no is liar. Then he began to laugh. And again he quickly ran. Krishna again began to run. And one after one, the flowers from his hair going on.
Falling down.
At that time, as if the flowers are telling, Mother, you are not alone, we are also helping you and running with you. So you should try more. Krishna is now taking so long breath. I see that we will help you, so run quickly. We are also running. Understand this? That flowers one by one coming, it seems that they are also running. So Yashoda quickly took any
stone
and hit it like, oh,
I'm throwing to you.
At once, and he from behind she catch hold of Krishna. Now he took a stick in his right hand and left hand, taking the right hand of Krishna, and wanted to beat him. And Krishna was hiding himself here in back of Yashoda and weeping, don't beat me, mother, don't beat me. Very
long,
in a long breath. At last Yashoda Maiya becomes merciful. I will not beat you, but I will bind you in the same motor girdle. You are both guilty, helping each other. So we must punish you both. And then he took to that his courtyard and tried to bind him. He took one of his rope and tried to bind him.
His waist.
This rope was so long, more than 2-3 yards. And Krishna, this rest,
waist,
was so like 12 only fingers.
12 fingers measurement.
And golden chain was here, with tinkling.
Yes.
Bell. But this rope could not go one round even. Then Yashoda Maya is thinking that how it became. In the meantime, there came so many sakhis of Yashoda Maya. And they saw that Krishna is so loudly weeping and doing like this.
Rubbing his eyes.
And Ganga and Jamunas are flowing from his eyes. And he khob lamba lamba shwas. He was taking so long. And so frightened. They all requested Yashoda Maya, Sakhi, give up. Don't beat Krishna. In your old days, he has come from your home. You should be merciful to this boy. So, usko chhod de, mane?
Leave him.
Leave him.
Give up him. But Yashoda Maya told that you should bring more ropes. And they were laughing and saying that Yashoda cannot bind him. Because Brahma, the creator, has not written in his Krishna
forehead
that anyone can bind Krishna. But they were looking and
clapping
and laughing. What Yashoda does. So many ropes, not only so many ropes, from neighbor houses. So many ropes were come. And they were tightened together. It became so
longer.
But they could not
make one round.
One round even, two fingers less. Why? Krishna is supreme personality of Godhead, you know. So he wished that Mother Yashoda should not bind me. If she is binding, I cannot play with boys. They are standing there, Madhumangal, Subal and Sridham and all others are there. I cannot. So Mother Yashoda should not bind. Oh, my very dear, beloved, also gopis, my friends, are waiting for me. Cows are waiting for me. If I am not going there, they will not give milk. When Krishna will go there, automatically they will give milk. Otherwise, their calf will not make the cause of milking. They will not give to their children also. They will kick them. But when Krishna will go and seeing Krishna, they will give from the milk from their hearts. So how I can do all these things? So Krishna wanted that Yashoda Maya should not mind. At once Jogmaya, the servant of
Krishna,
maid servant of Krishna, at once came. But anyone, if she was invisible, anyone could not see. That Krishna is not knowing anything, he is like what?
Like an innocent boy.
Innocent boy. And he is not remembering that I am
supreme
personality of Godhead. And I have so much power. But Jogmaya at once came and did miracle that Krishna vest is like same and all ropes together going so long but not rounding one even.
Time.
Two angles.
Two fingers.
On each round when she tried. Only two, not three, not one, not a four or so much. Only two rounds. What is this? This is the thing, that if any devotee purely following uttama bhakti, like anna bilashita sunyam jnan karma dhanabritam anukulena krishna anushilanam. He is practicing so much. Shamanam, kirtanam, vishnu, smaranam, padu, sevanam, archanam, bandhanam.
Dasya-sakkamatma-nivedanam.
Like giving of everything in the renounced order, even like Narada and Sukadeva Goswami, like Shankar or others. But by doing so, anyone cannot control Krishna. Krishna should be merciful. Krishna is always merciful to us. So if there are no two things, if we are thinking that Krishna is so merciful, I should not do anything. Krishna is merciful, so he will sprinkle merciful. Come and merciful. Like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to door to door, not devotees came to Mahaprabhu. So it may be like so. Then you will have not, you cannot control Krishna. And if you are only exercising in devouring, practicing bhakti yoga, and lakhs births, you cannot have a darshan of Krishna. Both things be there. In Krishna power, I think that supreme power is bhakta-vatsalya. What bhakta-vatsalya?
Favor of the devotees.
If any devotees is practicing so hard, not taking anything, quite fasting, always weeping, and if Krishna is merciful to them, realizing their kashta, sufferings, he becomes so soft, his heart melts, and quickly he gives darshan. But only we are doing like Yashoda, whole day, from morning till midday, practicing so much, he could not mind. So any devotee, by practicing Krishna, even pure bhakti, we cannot have darshan of Krishna. But when our practice plus Krishna mercy are together, at once quickly he will be controlled and he will be seen. So we should try to follow Rupa Sanatana, always practicing bhakti yoga so hardly. If anyone following Ekadashi, like we follow now, eating, drinking whole day, always our mouth is running. What?
Salivating.
always. This thing, another thing, something, that thing, whole day and night. Will Krishna be merciful there? Not there. Oh, he is happy. He is taking and he is happy. But anyone not taking anything, no sleeping night for 3 days, nothing taking, always weeping, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. In Vrindavan, in a very solid refresh also, then Krishna mercy may come. That way he has not taken anything. If you chastise your boy and your boy became to weep and rolling down, then mother will give up his all things and he will come and satisfy that boy. So like this. So we should not depend on our practices of bhakti yoga. But also on the other hand, without this you cannot have the mercy. So both things should be there. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has given an example for this. Marjaranyaya and
Markatnaya.
Markatnaya means Like monkeys and like cats.
Monkey logic and kitten logic.
When monkey, any monkey, with his child, wants to jump from one tree to another, the children of monkey at once jumps
on the back.
On the back of
mother.
Or here.
Stomach.
A stomach or here. Mother and not to do anything. She will jump only. But this, if the child
baby monkey
anyhow
falls down,
then mother never takes again like a son and gives up that boy forever. But generally it is not so. So mother is not doing anything, but mercy is there that he should go on his back or his lap, and she will jump from one place to another. So a devotee should always practicing so much. In one, and like cat. Cat has nothing to do.
Kitten.
Kitchen.
Kitten.
Nothing to do. They will do only meow meow, and his mother will come and take in his mouth and take one place to another. In Ramana Sampradaya, there are two kinds of Vaishnava like this. They depend on Krishna and one on their practices. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Try to mix both. And then easily Krishna will be controlled. So we should do practices so much, pure practices, continuous, but also weeping for mercy. And then mercy will come and we will easily control Krishna. He gave an example more. A person fell down in a well. And he was trying himself to come out, but he could not. He was trying so much. In the meantime, any person came and he threw out a rope
in
the ground. See, if that person who is falling down on the well, he will take it and then he can pull. But if he is not taking
tightening,
then what he can do? So Krishna is like pulling, but if you are not
holding
off, then we cannot have that bhakti or darshan of Krishna. When Krishna saw that Yashoda mother is praying Krishna, God, Narayan, this boy has come from my womb, and from very beginning in morning and up to midday, I am trying to bind him, but I could not do. So she was like weeping, tears were coming, face is like reddish face, and she became so worried. He was about to weep. Sakhis were seeing this, his face, and Krishna also saw. At once, he became so merciful. And Kripyasi Sabandane. Tishva parishramam.
Krishna
saw how hard labor is doing my mother to tighten me. And his eyes, so sweats are coming from here and there. At once Krishna became merciful, and only one rope was sufficient for binding Krishna. In half, she binded Krishna, and half she binded the okal. But in what way? He tightened that rope from here, from the side of his stomach. And in the end here he gave one knot, and again she tightened that grandal motor. And he gave very tightened knots there. Krishna was weeping though, so many boys were coming, Yashoda told that, look after this boy. And anything is done, at once tell me. And she quickly went to do his householder jobs or to
churning.
But his mind was there. Though by bodily he went, she went there. But always thinking that, how my boy? Why I did so? I have done wrong. But there was no way. Chastising herself. No. And here Krishna, with all the boys, first he was weeping. When Yashoda mother
went away.
At the same time, Baldev returned from the house of Upananda with his mother. His mother went inside to see, look after Yashoda, and Baldev came directly to
Krishna.
The council of Krishna, all friends and Krishna. And he looked that Krishna was weeping, and there were some signs, like kajal and water here. And he saw that Krishna is bended. Who did it? And he became very furious. Who did it? He wanted to know. But Madhvangal came and told in his ear, "Are you Mother Yashoda? Oh, Mother." Then he was also frightened. He was so furious. He wanted to say, who has binded? If not Yashoda, then he could do not have anything. Or he has
untied it.
But then he became frightened. Oh, there must be something. And then all the boys were clapping, "Oh, Sri Krishna.
Today you get a good lesson."
So they were clapping and laughing, and Krishna also began to laugh. Now his weeping was
stopped.
And playing with the boys. At once, Madhumangal has a proposal, that we should try to
untie.
So Madhumangal first went. In the meantime, Subal told, "I will do." Sridham told, "I will do." All well.
Fighting.
Fighting within them. Who will do? But anyone could not do. At last they proposed that Krishna should himself do. He wanted to do, but his hands not so sufficient to reach that knot. He could not do. At last Krishna gave a proposal, because he reminded that Narada has given
Nalkubar and Marika.
They were so false ego, taking birth in very high family, rich family in the world, richest family in the whole world, Kuber. And so were very beautiful in the world, very learned also. So all these things were in them. So false ego was also there. They were playing in a pond with naked
ladies,
Ashpara. Yes. Narada was going, walking. He saw that, they are like a tree. They have no sense, no shame, nothing more than a tree. But the ladies at once quickly came out of the water and they
covered
with cloths, and from there they began to
do pranam
to Narada. But these two
drunkards
and no shame having, they were abusing them. "Why you went there? And why this old gentleman came?"
There's no way to go.
So he was also doing something like, and he was calling all. Narada told that, "You have become like a tree. You are my friend's son." Kuber was his friend, because Narada Rishi always used to go to Shankar, and this Kuber was Shishya, disciple of Shankar. So they were friends. So he became so merciful to these boys and told, "I will make you so pure. Go at once and be like a tree for some years. At once you should." And telling this, they became to be like a tree, and then realized, oh,
he's so powerful.
Narada is so powerful. He has told, and at once we are going to be a tree. At once they quickly run, and they fell on the lotus feet of Narada. Save us, save us. Be kind to us. We have done so much offenses in your lotus feet. Now we are repenting and realizing. Narada told that, that I wanted, that you should realize. Now I am giving chance to you that you will be tree surely, because I have told like so. But we will be tree in Gokul. And after some lakhs years, some years means lakhs, and you will be tree there, waiting for Krishna. And when in the last of Dwapar Yug, Krishna will appear there, then mercifully he will remind you, and quickly he will touch you anyhow, and you will be liberated. And you then you will have bhakti.
Dwapar Yug bhi sab diye chilen na aage.
Satya Yuga. He gave this course to them in Satya Yuga. And after two yugas, and then they were waiting, like doing tapasya.
Austerity.
Austerity. Their arms are branches like this. Can you be one day like doing so? Very hard. And someone cutting their here, there, taking their barks, because the tree is very famous for their barks and their juice. Anyone, anywhere, broken this. Then at once anyone can take, and they were so very powerful. So thousand and lakhs years they were waiting for Krishna. At last, in Dwapar Yug this, Krishna remembered this, and he wanted to fulfill the desire of his devotee, Narada's desire, that Krishna will liberate you. So Krishna told that we should go to play outside of this courtyard, and thus all began to do like this, to push, and Krishna also began to pull. Quickly they came to the gate, and very near to gate that tree were there. Very narrow gate. Krishna came out of the trees on this side, and the grendel motor was in this side. Krishna not touched the trees, but this rope touched the grendel, and rope touched the Krishna one side, and another side grendel, and grendel touched the true tree. At once, what? A current came from Krishna through rope. It went to
mortar,
and from mortar
true tree.
At once,
tumultuous sound,
with a very great sound. Why this sound has come? All began to search, and they quickly all Nanda Baba, Yashoda, Upananda, whole Brajavasi assembled there to say what happened. They said they came at once, and they saw that Krishna is there, so many friends are there, and trees were not
falling straight.
Otherwise all the boys has been spent. They went like this and this. Nanda Baba come running from Brahmandaga. And when Krishna saw that my father is coming, he began to again weep. Very loudly, very. Baba, Baba, like this. And tears coming so much. Doing like this. Breathing like so. So now Yashoda also came, and from a distance he was seeing that Nanda Baba is there, and all Brajavasi are there, older persons, and Sing Desi was so frightened and ashamed that due to me it has been done like so. And if in this stage Krishna has died, then what to do? So Yashoda was so nervous that his all tears were dry. And she became like wood and she. Nanda Baba came at once to Krishna in his lap and told, "Who has done this? Who has abandoned you?" Repeatedly he asked. But Krishna only weeping, not answering. Anyhow, when Baba repeated this, I said, "Who has done this? I will punish." Then Krishna told in his ear very silently that, "Mother, mother." He became so angry. "I have never seen her
being so cruel.
So cruel. Now today he has been so cruel. Formerly is a little better or anything." Then quickly he
untied.
Now Krishna somewhat
pacified.
And then Baba took off one
Gurdhani.
Gurdhani means
laddu
and gave to Krishna. But Krishna not eating, only doing so. Then he told that we should go to take bath in Brahmanda. He took Baldev Prabhu here and Krishna here and went very grave, not speaking a word to anyone. He took bath and he met Krishna, rubbed all these things, kajal and everything, and then again took him. Now it was about 6 in evening and he went to his home. Rukmini Devi, Rohini and all other took Yashoda Maiya from there. She was not in a stage to walk, but by the help she came in his room and weeping bitterly. "Today no preparation, no bhog to Thakurji, nothing, all were weeping, Yashoda Maiya." And Nanda Baba not telling any word, very grave. He gave Krishna and Baldev the milk of cows in mouth with Mishri. Mishri, you know?
Sugar candy.
Sugar candy. And thus their stomach was fulfilled. And he was sitting in the council. Mother Rohini and all were so worried for Yashoda Maiya that she will die if Krishna is not coming in his life. So they took Baldev and told Baldev, and they came to Nanda Baba and Krishna and told that at once you should go and
pull him.
So because Rohini Maiya or other ladies cannot touch Krishna in the lap of Nanda Baba, and he was so grave, so they were standing somewhat nearer but not so much nearer. Baldev went and try to do like him and to pull, but Krishna was so strong today that he did like this and Baldev Prabhu fell down on the earth. And he was now looking, "Oh, he is more stronger than me today." Then all the ladies came more nearer to Nanda Baba. They told to Krishna, "Come on, your mother is weeping. I will never come. Where you will sleep? I will sleep with Baba. To whom you will play? I will play with Dau Bhaiya and Baba. Father. What you will take?
Milk and sugar candy."
"Oh, Baba, Father will give me milk and
sugar candy.
Sugar candy from the womb of so many cows. I will take. Will you not come? Your mother is so weeping." "No, I will not. Like, no, no." But at once Rohini told that if your mother will die, oh, then at once Krishna began to weep so loudly. Mother, mother, mother. And he did like that from the lap of Nanda Baba. At once, Rohini came and took in his lap. Nanda Baba also was weeping so much. All were weeping. Baldev was also. And weeping, Rohini Maiya took Krishna. And up till now, Yashoda was not weeping. He had become like a stone. But when Rohini Devi gave Krishna in the lap of
Yashoda Maiya,
now he began to weep loudly. Krishna was also, all were weeping. Just Rohini Maiya quickly went to the kitchen room and he was began to cook something. And thus, Yashoda Maiya took Krishna in his lap, in her lap, and covered and gave his rest. After that, cooking was done, and she requested all to take some prasadam offered first to Thakurji, and then Nand Baba came with Upananda and all other his senior brothers and junior brothers, and they began to take. Nand Baba took Krishna on his lap, and after that he gave Krishna and Baldev, and also all their taking. But when their taking was finished, then he also called Yashoda, "Oh, you can come and take prasadam." But she was only weeping. Then Nanda Baba told Krishna in his Krishna ear that, "Oh, pull on,
drag your mother."
To your mother. And Krishna, running, he went to her mother and catch hold of his well and
push.
Began to push and drag Yashoda Maiya. Anyhow, after that, Rohini also helped, all the Sakhis helped Yashoda. Anyhow, Yashoda came, and then she took also remnant of all, and all were now happy. Krishna took, Yashoda Maiya took Krishna in his lap and went to sleeping room because it was night. Gaur Praman. Oh. Like this. So we should see, only our practice will not do. If a love and affection like Mother Yashoda, like gopis, like friend, will come. But how it will come? Only by the mercy of Krishna, by the mercy of any so highest class of devotee, plus our efforts or sadhana. But not sadhana that we are doing. It will not do. How it will do? I am telling a very little story. There was a devotee. He was doing Sravanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam Pad Sevan. Also, observing all the rules and regulations of bhakti, he was detached to worldly thing, and he was a shade of tamarind tree. You know tamarind tree? The leaves very
small size.
And tree so big. He preferred leaves. So he was doing tapasya,
austerity.
Austerity, sometimes in trance, sometimes here and there, very hardly. Fasting so many days, doing this. Once Narad came. When Narad came, he did pranam, shastang pranam, and told, "Oh, Rishi, where you are going? Oh, I am going to Vaikunth. Why you are going? I am going to see Narayan and to please him and to have some benediction. Can you tell my one request to Narayan?" "Yes, I can do. What is your request?" He told that, "Only you should ask Narayan. A devotee is from 1,000 years. He's making so much
hard austerities,
and chanting your name and everything. So when a day will come that he will have your darshan. Narad went in Vaikunth, and after he talked with Narayan, also he requested that a devotee is in the way, meet me. And he has asked, oh, Narayan told, I know him. He thought something and then told, go and told, tell to this devotee that there are leaves in tamarind tree. Count one by one, all leaves, uncountable. But anyhow, they can't be counted. So as there are leaves, in that so many births after that, you will have my darshan. Narad was unhappy somewhat by this answer of Vaikuntha Pati. And he was returning, but not that very way. He was passing by another way, but that devotee was waiting for him. So when he saw that Narad is going by that way, oh, Narad Rishi, come on, come on, come on, I want to have my answer. Have you asked? Narad came, returned and told, yes, I did question to Narayan. He was very eager to hear what answer, but Narad was feeling some shame to tell. But anyhow, when he repeated to know, then he told that, oh, in this tree, there are so many leaves. I think that if anyone count, in that very birth, so much births, after that, you can have darshan. Oh, hearing this, he began to
overjoyed
and jump. Oh, now I have not no hope that I will have darshan of Narayan. But now I have hope that surely I will have darshan after so many births. In
this coming limit.
No. Unlimited time, but now I have come in limited time. That after these years are past, I will surely have the darshan. So he began to dance, oh Hari Sri Hari, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari. That Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol. And at the same time, at once, Narayan came on Garud and he gave darshan. Then Narayan told him, you are lawyer? Why you told like this? Then how I will show my face to others? You told me another thing and you just came. He told that as he was doing practices for bhakti, it was not sufficient. He was not observed, always weeping and observing. And now he has forgotten everything, quietly observed, dancing and taking them, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol. I could not remain. And that is why I am...
I broke my promise.
I am bound to come. So, I think our practices are not like so. So it may take, you will have darshan, but no guarantee that when. It may take lakhs and lakhs births, koti births, koti birth. But when we will come, there is hope. And what hope? If you will do like Raghunath Das Goswami, not like Raghunath, no heart. But if you will take shelter in the lotus feet of Raghunath Das Goswami, Rupa Goswami, Sarva Damodar Raya Ramanand, or any devotees like this, always repenting, oh Krishna, where you are. Then quickly, so quickly, he can come. And he will bound to be controlled and to give darshan. So devotees don't want their darshan, only want to chant in this way. Always weeping. light. Hey Lalite.
Hey Radhe.
Hey Radhe Lalite. Brajadevi ke chalalite. Hey Nanda Suno Kuta. Shri Govardhan Kalpapadap Tale Kalindi Vane Kuta. Goshantavit Sarvatau Khedai Mahabhivalo Vande Rupasana. So we are doing Vandana to Jasoda Maiya. A lap like this, it can bind Krishna. But we want to follow Rup Goswami, like Rup Manjari. We want to be the Hardashi. That more controlled Krishna will be more controlled by this way, more than mother. So you should follow Chaitanya Mahaprabhu principles. In the line of Swamiji, he has taught you all these things so well. Try to go deep, not outwardly only. I'm thinking that what we are doing outwardly anything, not so deeply. We should try to develop our love and affection, not making high buildings, not big, making all these things. This should be simple, but our love should be very pure and high class of. Then Krishna will be controlled easily. Gaur Pramanam.
Gaur Pramanam De.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Father knows that I have come here.
Yes.
No?
Yes, but he's in another state. He's not in California.
No.
He wanted to come.
Seven days from then.
Everybody for karting in India, but I'm not coming.
Oh, I have to come.
Yeah, my problem
if
about
you is. I will take your soul with me, my pocket and there.
Yeah, but I travel 3 hours to get to visa and choose.
Now you're so right.
I know you're going to do it. I want to tell you, if you don't give me visa, how can I get to your meditation in Italy?
I will get you.
I can't
just get a visa for him. Come in my heart. Take away all my worldly desires.
Jaya Satchinanda, Jaya Satchinanda.
By Krishna's mercy, I'll be in Hawaii with you, and my mother will be there, and all my friends in Maui.
Govinda Prabhu Dharma Devi Govinda. Shri Radhe. Radhe, 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 Jai, 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 Shri Radhe.
Jai, Jai, Jai,
Shri Radhe.
More loudly.
Jai, Jai, Shri Radhe.
Hey!